The birch bark canoe was a fascinating project. It's something I've always wanted to do, to build a birch bark canoe. But one of the reasons that I set out to do this was that so often today we look at the skills and the techniques and the knowledge of our ancestors and we look down on it as though, you know, our carbon fiber, our plastic is so superior. And in fact, I'm not sure that's always the case. In my experience, having used so many of the old skills and techniques, I find them to be actually, in many cases, superior to modern equipment.
All the ribs are in. Now, look, you see that? We've got a real shape to that keel. It's pivoting over the middle. It's absolutely perfectly balanced. You're a bloody clever man.
Sure
but
help.
That is
sure
that's what we call rocker, and that means that the boat will pivot and turn nicely in the water. It's beautiful, absolutely staggering.
The birch bark canoe is a case in point. Canoeists always say, yeah, they're beautiful, but you know, they couldn't do this, they couldn't do that. But when you really start to look at the literature surrounding them, you see illustrations of them running rapids, you see illustrations of them being poled up shallows with very heavy loads on board. These boats must have been much tougher than we give them credit for.
The moment of truth. Shall I take it for a spin?
Try it out. Please do.
What I hoped that we would do is we'd build a birch bark canoe and then we would take that birch bark canoe to the Missinaibie River, an old fur trade river, and take it down the river. That was my aim, and I hoped that the birch bark canoe would be an ambassador for the skills and the knowledge of the Algonquin and other peoples of Canada who created this craft.
Worth all the effort, Pinock. She's beautiful.
That's good.
Actually, the way it turned out was slightly different. We discovered that there were cracks and holes in the bark that led us to suspect that the bark may not be strong enough to cope with the white water. And I had to make the agonizing decision not to take the canoe down that river, although I'd set my heart on that. The reason that the bark has a problem is nothing to do with birch bark canoes or the skills of the past. It's to do with modern day pollution. Today it's harder to find the bark with the same quality of the past because of acid rain and other influences, global warming, who knows. Today the lenticels in the bark are larger and they cause greater weaknesses and the bark is not as flexible and as resilient as it used to be. The strange thing was, a few days before we began to build the birch bark canoe, I paddled an antique one that was made in 1915. I think there are going to be very few plastic or fiberglass boats that really live as long as birch bark does. So in a strange way, instead of being an ambassador for the skills of the past, the canoe turned out to be a different sort of ambassador, one that reminds us how important it is to cherish and take care of wild places and the species which exist there.